Hello and warm welcome to all of you. Today I am here with a new and very important chapter of the history, chapter number 1, the French Revolution. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the following topics: the introduction of the chapter, the causes of French Revolution, outbreak of French Revolution, how France became constitutional monarchy, how France abolished monarchy and become a republic, the reign of terror, a directory rules France, woman revolution, the abolition of slavery, the revolution and the everyday life of the people in the France, rise of the Napoleon Bonaparte, etc. Today I am here with the part 1. In this part I am going to discuss today the introduction of the chapter and the causes of the French Revolution. On the morning of 14 July 1789, the city of Paris was in a state of alarm. The king had commanded troops to move into the city. Rumors spread that he would soon order the army to open fire upon the citizens. Some 7,000 men and women gathered in front of the town hall and decided to form a militia. Students, militia means people, army. They broke into number of government buildings in search of arms. Finally, a group of several hundred people marched toward the eastern part of the city and storming's attack. The fortress prison, fortress means group of fort, the Bastille, where they hoped to find hoarded ammunition. Hoarded means store, and ammunition means weapon. In the armed fight that followed, the commander of Bastille was killed and the prisoner released, though there were only 7 of them. Yet the Bastille was hated by all because it stood for the despotic power of the king. The fortress was demolished and its stone fragments were sold in the market to all those who wished to keep a souvenir of its destruction. Here, despotic means unlimited power, and souvenir means a memory. The day that followed showed some rioting both in Paris and the countryside. Most people were protesting against the high prices of the bread. Much later, when historians look back upon this time, they show it as the beginning of the chain of events that ultimately led to execution of the king in France. Though most people at the time did not anticipate this outcome, how and why did this happen? Students, now I will explain in detail. The French Revolution was started in the morning of 14 July 1789. I'm repeating, 14 July 1789, with the series of events started by the middle class people of the France. The people of France revolted against the cruel regime of monarchical form of government. Here, one point to be noted is, students, these were the days when most part of the world was under monarchical form of government. At the time, France was ruled by Louis XVI of the Bourbon family. He came into power in 1774. At the time, he was only 20 years old. He married Austrian Princess Marie Antoinette. On the morning of 14 July 1789, the king ordered the army to move into the city. And people of the France feared that he would soon order army to open fire on the citizen. So on the other hand, around 7,000 men and women form militia and attack on government buildings in search of weapons. They even attack on the fortress prison Bastille, with the hope to find a weapon from it. They kill the commander of Bastille and release all the prisoners, though at the time only 7 prisoners were dead. They demolished Bastille because Bastille was the symbol of unlimited power, means symbol of despotic power of the king. Some people kept its stone fragment as souvenir after the destruction of Bastille. After 14 July 1789, more rioting activity started in capital city Paris and even in countryside. Most people protesting against the high prices of the bread. Destruction of Bastille was followed by the beginning of chain of events that at last led to the execution of the king and royal family. This revolution had given the ideas of liberty, fraternity means brotherhood, and equality to the world. Now, here the question is, how and why did all this happen? For this, we have to discuss the causes of French Revolution in detail. The number one, social causes. Number two, economic causes. Number three, political causes. Number four, growing of middle class in French society. And number five, the contribution of philosopher. Students, in this part we have discussed the beginning of the French Revolution, and even I mentioned causes of the French Revolution. In part 2, we will discuss all the causes of French Revolution in detail. Thank you for your cooperation and eagerly wait for more interesting part of the chapter.